Coming up on this month's New Look INTV, we have an exclusive interview with the world's greatest Formula One driver, Lewis Hamilton.
I love when it rains because those are the days I can really show you that driving-wise, I can show you what I'm made of.
INEOS Hygienics has a new product on the shelves. We catch up with renowned designer Toby Ecuyer. Hype or hyperbole? Can hydrogen really fuel our future? And we get the latest from around the INEOS Group. This is INTV. This month's INTV is coming to you from the hallowed halls, the heritage centre for the Mercedes-AMG Petronas Formula One team. The Formula One history in this room is awe-inspiring. Every single championship winning car for the team is housed here. But they need to find some more room, because after yet another record-breaking season, history is still being written.
Lewis's achievements make him part of the best sports stars that have ever existed. He has won 7 titles, more race wins and more pole positions than any other driver. And when you look at the landscape, there is only a few sports people today that stand out in the way Lewis has. But he's still not finished. He's in his best years as a racing driver. His ambitions remain high. Formula One is who he is. And I think there is much more to achieve together.
Welcome, Lewis Hamilton, and a huge congratulations from everyone here at INEOS on another amazing season.
Thank you. How
does it feel? I mean, what you've achieved this season, making those record-breaking achievements, how do you feel at the end of the season?
Tired, exhausted, honestly, and it's been just remarkable to think what we've achieved. I don't think any of us expected a year like this, and I'm really proud of the team and what we've achieved.
And the last couple of weeks have been particularly tough for you with COVID. How did it feel having to miss out on your second last Grand Prix?
It was the first time I've missed a race in 27 years. That's how long I've been racing. I think to get through that and then be able to come to the last race, I was really grateful. And I'm now even more consciously aware than ever before, and just thinking about those people around me and keeping myself safe moving forwards.
You have phenomenal performance when you're driving in wet conditions. What is it that you do that other people don't do? And do you actually prefer wet conditions to give you an advantage?
It's not that I prefer wet conditions to give me an advantage. It's I know how good I am. But on a dry day, it makes it harder for people to see. You know, yeah. People will use an excuse, oh, you've got the car, or the tires were in the window. So I love when it rains because those are the days I can really show you that driving-wise, I can show you what I'm made of. And yeah. That's where my real skill, I'm able to magnify. I'm able to be super reactive to those really difficult conditions. And that's been a skill I've harnessed over the years racing in England in the rain. But it's not just that. But I can't tell you everything because I don't like people knowing.
Absolutely. What for you was the outstanding moment on the track in this season, 2020 Formula One season?
Silverstone finishing the race with one tire blown. I think it's taking a knee in Austria the first time, and then I would say the real pinnacle of the year would be Turkey.
You must have been aware of the milestones that you might have been able to break during the season. Did that play on your mind? Did you approach this season any differently, knowing you got those milestones so close?
I knew that this year I was fighting for a 7th world title, but I just put that at the back and compartmentalize it, and I take it one race at a time. I know what I've got to do to get to where I need to be. Yeah. If you worry about the things you can't control all the time, you just drive yourself crazy. So what I can control is I know that I've got to study before. I know that I'm good, but I got to keep that thing on the track. I know I've got to get my start perfect. I know I need to master my strategy. I know I need to master the tires. So, and with work, I know I can do those things. So those are the things I focus on, what I can control.
How different is the Lewis Hamilton at the end of 2020 to the Lewis Hamilton at the end of 2019? How has this year changed you, do you think?
I think this year came to light that all the greatness of the driving and the success was for something far, for a much bigger picture. And now I see that, and now I know that my next steps, I work towards how I can utilize that the platform with more efficiency, how I can utilize, make sure when I speak, I know it carries weight.
You've won everything in Formula One now. I mean, what motivates you into next season?
Implementing change, that for me is what I want to see in 2021. It's empowering people and working on how we can do that more together, I think. That's what I'm looking forward to hopefully doing with INEOS.
Yeah, we'd certainly return that 100 times. I really appreciate your time and giving us this time. It's been fantastic and really enjoyed this. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Toby Ecuyer, the designer of the Grenadier 4x4, has turned his hand to something a bit smaller. The INEOS Hygienics dispenser is such an amazing piece of kit that we wanted to find out more about its design from the person who knows it best.
I mean, I've designed all sorts of peculiar things in my life, but this was something that I'd never really done before, but I loved the challenge of it. The shape of it really came about as a result of its function, and for me the biggest challenge was to have a clarity about it. You've got this aluminium frame that runs around the outside, but then where your hand goes in, there's gentle radiuses as you sort of curve in. It's subtle, but it's more inviting. The real challenge of designing something so simple, it really has to be super precise, because the second that something's a couple of mil off, it may as well be a meter off. And so to get the radiuses exactly right, there was a whole series of sort of manufacturing questions we had to ask, because if we couldn't have maintained that in actual manufacture, then we would have had to change the design for it. The amount of work that went into making it as simple as it looks is incredible, really. So there was a very deep diving into getting everything to line up exactly, which is really time consuming. And having that level of thought is a really good example of British design and Swiss engineering. I'm really pleased with the end result, probably because, you know, it's a really remarkable thing to imagine something, then draw it, and then to actually have the product sat there that works and works well, doing the job and ticking all the boxes that we put in its way. It's a really important piece of equipment, and I like the fact that we've invested the time and money into actually designing a really elegant and well-designed piece of kit. And I think we've definitely done that.
INEOS has just signed an agreement with Hyundai to share knowledge about an exciting new technology. A technology that will change the way we look at energy. A technology that is happening right under the bonnet of this car. The world is searching for a new, reliable energy solution. And there's one chemical that is stealing the limelight. INTV takes a closer look at the molecule that could fuel our future.
As countries race to become carbon neutral, there is one energy solution that could offer the most potential. It can already run a car, and one day it could power your home, your town, or even an entire city. It's not batteries, it's not solar, and it's not wind. But it can work in harmony with all these. It's hydrogen, the most abundant element in the universe. For over 100 years, scientists have understood that hydrogen can be used to generate energy. Fuel cell technology uses the gas to create electricity, with the only byproduct being water. Pioneered in the 19th century and used by NASA on space shuttles in the 80s, it has been developed to become more affordable, which is why hydrogen vehicles are no longer science fiction.
As far as we can tell, there's no limitations to hydrogen as a fuel source. It's been around for a long time now, was used in the Apollo missions, but when it comes to the vehicles, it unlocks everything for us. The technology has become a lot more viable over the past, I would say, 10 years, just as the raw cost of the materials has come down, as well as the actual amount of materials, such as the rare earth metals that go in there. The content of that has started to reduce as we refine the production process as well. The main advantages for hydrogen fuel cell technology, particularly in road transport, one is zero emissions. The only emissions out of the car is water vapour and heat. Second is a very quick refill time. So this will refill from completely empty to full in just over 5 minutes. The other advantage with hydrogen fuel cell, perhaps the most important one at the moment, is the fact it purifies air as it drives. So the emissions that come out the back of the car is actually cleaner than the air that comes in.
Companies such as Hyundai adopting this NASA-proven tech is just the beginning, because it's the gas's potential beyond vehicles that could really help hydrogen take off. Fuel cells don't have to store energy, they make energy. So they can be scaled to fit all types of uses. They could power trains, ships, or even chemical plants. But in order to scale up, you need lots of hydrogen. And this is INEOS's area of expertise. For decades, INEOS and their business Inovin have been making hydrogen using electrolysis, producing up to 300,000 tons a year at their sites all over Europe. That is equivalent to 8 million gallons of diesel, which would be a substantial kickstart to the industry. Beyond this, when the production of hydrogen is linked to renewable energy, its impact on carbon emissions is even more impressive.
So you can link the manufacture of hydrogen from water to renewables. It helps you solve also the intermittency of renewables. When the wind doesn't blow, the sun doesn't shine, you stop making hydrogen. When it does shine, you make hydrogen. And so at the times when you're generating power with renewable technologies, you can able to capture that power in the form of hydrogen and then use it at will. Power your homes, industry, and vehicles with it.
INEOS's knowledge of power-to-gas technology is one of the reasons why they have just entered an agreement with Hyundai to share technology around the chemical and its potential as a clean, sustainable fuel for the future.
It's one of the ways in INEOS that we see for reducing our own emissions significantly over the coming years and working within and towards the objectives of all the nation states, really, to move to a net zero economy by 2050.
Despite the pandemic, it's been a busy few months at INEOS. Here's a roundup of all the latest news from around the business.
In the continued effort to reach a zero carbon future, INEOS has launched a new business aimed at building clean hydrogen capacity across Europe. Based in the UK, the business will be an important step towards helping decarbonize many businesses and sectors. This is one of the many initiatives that INEOS are spearheading to tackle carbon emissions. Earlier this year, INEOS signed a deal with ENGIE to supply wind power to their Antwerp sites, the largest in Belgium's industrial history. And in December, a further deal was signed with RWE, meaning together there will be a combined saving of 2 million tons of CO2, the equivalent of taking 160,000 cars off the road each year.
INEOS Europe celebrated another year of driving sustainability in the chemicals industry after receiving a gold score from EcoVadis, a trusted provider of business sustainability ratings that examine more than 65,000 businesses across 200 sectors in 160 countries. Recognizing INEOS's particular commitment to environmental performance, the company was placed in the top 3% in this category and the top 4% for its overall sustainability in the chemical sector.
INEOS Hygienics launched their first television commercial in October, unveiling a campaign featuring star names such as Lewis Hamilton and Ben Ainsley. Premiering on ITV and Channel 4, it also features 7-time Tour de France winners, the INEOS Grenadiers.
Whether you're chasing every last second or just counting them down, you can do it with confidence using INEOS Hygienics.
And it doesn't stop there. INEOS Hygienics are also proud to announce they are the official hygiene supplier to Premier League football club Tottenham Hotspur. State-of-the-art dispensers have been installed in the new stadium and around the training grounds, whilst personal sanitizer products will be supplied to the men's and women's teams on their travels.
This November saw the opening of FC Lausanne Sport's brand new home, the Tuileries Stadium. And so far, the team have had a positive start to the season since promotion. The state-of-the-art 11,950-seater stadium features a host of innovative and sustainable products, including a suitable wood alternative made from rice husks and the world's first 50% recycled plastic seat. And whilst there are no fans there now, when restrictions are lifted, it will form an important hub for the community going forward.
INEOS Automotive have announced it will be building its new 4x4, the Grenadier, at the former Mercedes-Benz site of Hambach. The site has a ready-made production line suitable for the Grenadier's size. This acquisition will give INEOS Automotive access to suppliers and markets and allow the production to go ahead in late 2021 while safeguarding the site and jobs in the area.
That's it for now. 20 shows down at the end of 2020. And with racing events about to get underway over Christmas in New Zealand, we thought we'd leave you with some exclusive footage of INEOS Britannia, our entry for next year's America's Cup. Thank you for watching, enjoy the holidays, and we'll see you again in 2021.